For today's lesson, we're going to practice using pivot tables and using our Excel formatting options with some of our own spreadsheets. So if you remember back when we did the unit on how computers work, we did a spreadsheet on just devices and their purpose. So open that one up first, and we're going to do a pivot table for this spreadsheet. Now remember, you're going to start with by clicking on something in the spreadsheet. So I'm just clicking on cell A1. We're going to go to Insert and click on Pivot Table. So hopefully this is familiar to you. And go ahead and say OK. So we've got our options here, and there's many things that you can do, but we only have two fields. So let's put in our purpose, and we've got things right there. And then maybe I want to count the purpose. So I can even just say how many I have of each. So that looks pretty good. If you want to kind of play around with it, you can even add in your other things if you want to see everything that you selected. Or not. So we've just got a nice little pivot table there. I can come over here in my options and I can create a pivot chart for this. And I'm going to do something like a pie chart. And then I can just kind of make some adjustments here. Maybe I want the words to actually show and I can see visually the same thing that my chart is telling me. I'm also going to rename things. So here is my pivot table and my data. And when you create a new one, I want you to name it as well. So I'm going to call this one my pivot table. So we've done one together. Then I want you to think of one on your own and then name all of your different options. And then also remember to put your name in the header if you haven't done that yet. I'm going to come back to my data. Go to Insert, and I'm going to say Header and Footer, and then remember to put your name in one of these sections. Then you're ready to save it and turn it in as a pivot table assignment. The next one we're going to try is your assignment list. So we worked on this, you even got a grade for it, and we list all the assignments that you completed or were assigned. The software that we used, the unit, was it an assignment or assessment, and did you complete it? So hopefully you have this already finished. You should have 50 or so assignments listed, and it should all be complete with something everywhere. Now we're going to turn this into a pivot table as well. One thing you might notice is that there's assignment two places, and that can be a little confusing. So let's change this assignment to assignment name. So we've got each column with a different header, and hopefully you've already put your name in the header, and you should have this tab name as assignment. So we have our software tab and we have our assignments tab. So if you haven't renamed your tabs, go ahead and do that now. We're going to do a right mouse click and go to rename. So let's make a pivot table. I'm going to start on cell A1 again. We're going to come here to Insert and click on pivot table. So it's going to select everything, and here we go. So we have a lot of data on this one, so we can really do a lot of things. Let's start by our units. So here's all the different units that we've had this semester. And let's put in the software that we used for each unit. So I have each unit and the software that we used all divided up. So that looks really cool. And I want to do some counting. And this value section will count for me if I don't have numbers to total. I want to know how many of them I completed, so I'm going to drag that right there. So you can see just with a quick glance that for computer history, I completed 7. Okay. Then I want to know how many of them were assignments and how many of them were assessments. So we've got a really nice looking pivot table here without having to go through all of our software. So if I had to look here at all my assignments, it would take me a long time to count everything. And my pivot table, which is sheet 1 right now, just does a nice glance. I could make this into a chart, but this is a pretty good table right here. So I'm going to go ahead and rename this tab as my pivot table. Okay, then I want you to go back to your assignments spreadsheet, come here, and then create another pivot table. You can just pick what you want it to look like, rename the tab, and then save it, and you're ready to turn this one in. A 2 of this assignment. Now for the last part of this assignment, I'm going to have you open up your Price a Computer spreadsheet, and you already should have the headers done. And we're going to make this into just a chart. We're not really going to do a pivot table on this. We could, but we don't have that much data. And another thing that's going to be helpful, this was mentioned in the video, is if you take out any of your blank rows. So I'm just going to go through and do that really quickly. And delete anything that doesn't insert here. Even though I have output, there's nothing here. So I'm going to go ahead and just fix this up. And go ahead and fix up yours. Keep my total. I don't even really need this paragraph for this part of the assignment, so I'm going to delete these rows too. So I have just my spreadsheet right here, and I want to use just the cart order and the cost and not the total in my chart. So when you learn how to do this, I'm going to highlight here. I'm going to use my control key. I'm going to highlight down here, and then I'm ready to do my chart. So I'm going to insert. I'm going to come over here to my charts, and let's just do another pie chart. And I've got my costs and which parts that I ordered. I move it off so I can kind of see everything. I can play around with the data. Maybe I want to add a chart title, so I'm going to come over here. I'm going to add a title. And you can make any other changes that you want to make. So I've got a nice graph going. I'm going to rename this. Chart. And then what I want you to do is think of something else that you can do to this spreadsheet. So it can be some formatting options that you learned, it could be a different chart, but think of one more thing to add. Make sure that you've labeled, renamed all any tabs that you have open, and then you're ready to save this. So this is a three-part assignment, and you're going to do something for your assignment spreadsheet, for your hardware spreadsheet, and for your Price a Computer.